In this video, we would like to talk about how you can optimize cBots. In cTrader, it is possible to create cBots with any number of customizable parameters affecting their behaviors such as order protection levels or default order volumes. This raises the question of how exactly traders can determine the optimal values of these parameters. Fortunately, cTrader offers a built-in tool that can handle optimization, saving traders valuable time. Think of optimization as a series of backtests. Each backtesting pass occurs on the same data but uses different values for any parameters coded in a cBot. To demonstrate how optimization works, we will use a cBot that can react to cases when fast or slow period moving averages cross the opposite moving averages. We want to be able to customize how many fast and slow periods the cBot receives data for. To do so, our cBot should have the suitable parameters. To define the optimal parameter values, we would need to extensively test how the cBot works in various market conditions and when given different values for the slow periods and fast periods parameters. We can make cTrader run these tests automatically and, at their conclusion, provide us with certain parameter values that allow the cBot to achieve the best possible results. To access cBot optimization, first, select an instance of the cBot you would like to optimize. Afterward, switch to the Optimization tab located just to the right of the Backtesting tab. As optimization is a series of backtests, you can configure the same settings as you would for regular backtesting. To do so, click on the cog icon and change the values in the newly opened menu. We will give more starting capital to our bot as we want it to have some sort of a safety cushion. To select the exact parameters cTrader would need to optimize, click on the Parameters button immediately to the right of the cog icon. In the newly appeared section, enable or disable the flags to the left of each parameter name to include or exclude these parameters from the optimization process. We do not yet want to try other moving average types, but we still want optimization to determine the optimal values of slow and fast periods that our cBot will consider on start. Next, we will define the exact criteria cTrader is going to use to select the optimal parameter values among the backtesting passes that it will conduct. To do so, click on the criteria button represented by the upward line icon. The settings for each criterion include two menus. In the menu to the left, select whether the criterion should be minimized or maximized. In the menu to the right, choose the criterion that should be minimized or maximized from a set of predefined options. New criteria can be added by clicking on Add Criterion. We will leave optimization criteria as they currently are. We want cTrader to maximize our net profit and the number of winning trades that our cBot makes. At the same time, we want to minimize the maximum equity drawdown percentage. Note that it is also possible to define custom optimization criteria using the GetFitness method. For the sake of brevity, this video does not cover this subject. To choose a specific optimization algorithm, click on the Algorithm button to the right of the Criteria button. The exhaustive search algorithm is highly accurate but resource-intensive. When the grid option is selected, cTrader creates a grid of all possible parameter values and runs all backtests required to test them. While this process is thorough, it can take a large amount of time. Fortunately, cTrader includes the genetic algorithm option. This algorithm emulates natural selection by considering each pass as an individual, the cBot parameters as genes, and the degree of fit to the optimization criteria as adaptability. This option is less resource-intensive than exhaustive search while still producing accurate results. To perform cBot optimization, select the range of historical data that cTrader will run backtesting bases on. To do so, use either the calendar slider at the top of the optimization tab or the menus to the left and right of it. We will choose 1 year as the optimization period. cTrader also allows for determining the exact percentage of the CPU resources allocated to the optimization process. To customize this setting, click on the Resources button to the left of the leftmost calendar menu. In the newly appeared section, drag the slider to either increase or decrease the CPU consumption. We will set it at about 60% to avoid loading the CPU too much. To launch the optimization procedure, click on the play button to the right of the rightmost calendar menu. After cTrader loads the historical data, you will see optimization passes added to the central screen in real time. At the top of the grid, you will also see the current number of passes, the elapsed time, and the remaining optimization time. Any completed passes will be marked with a green check mark. All passes during which your cBot has reached stopout will, instead, be marked with a gray check mark. In the central grid, cTrader will display several metrics for each backtesting pass, including the number of winning trades your cBot has made and the maximum equity drawdown percentage. Of particular note is the fitness column that displays a fitness score for each pass. Think of a fitness score as a metric that evaluates the degree to which a pass has maximized/minimized your chosen optimization criteria. Higher fitness scores are indicative of higher degrees of fit with these criteria. To quickly select the pass with the highest fitness score, simply enable the auto-select the best pass flag located just above the central grid. Note that you can enable the auto-select the best pass flag as optimization occurs, and cTrader will dynamically search for the best possible parameter values. After optimization concludes, we can see the pass that has achieved the fitness score. We can safely click on Apply next to the pass with the highest fitness score, and the parameter values used during this pass will be immediately applied to our cBot instance. As is the case with backtesting, the TradeWatch display will provide an equity chart and detailed trade statistics summarizing the actions taken by our cBot during a particular pass. Note that the equity chart is only displayed for 20 best passes from the central grid. The steadily increasing balance and equity lines just reinforce the fact that the chosen pass provided the parameter values necessary for our cBot to function effectively. We highly recommend conducting multiple rounds of optimization with different criteria to get an idea of what parameter values would be best for any cBots you have developed yourself or acquired from other developers.